ऑनरेबल गवर्नर श्री विद्यासागर राव जी, एजुकेशन मिनिस्टर श्री विनोद तावड़े जी, श्री मधुर भंडारकर जी, माय कैबिनेट कलीग्स, मेंबर्स ऑफ लेजिस्लेचर, ऑल द एमिनेंट पर्सनैलिटीज फ्रॉम डिफरेंट वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ फ्रॉम मुंबई एंड महाराष्ट्र, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एट द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट श्री उदय माहुरकर जी फॉर ऑथरिंग मार्चिंग विथ अ बिलियन. आई थिंक इट्स नॉट जस्ट अ क्रिटिकल एनालिसिस ऑफ प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी जी, बट इन फैक्ट इट्स अ कंप्लीट बुक ऑन अ न्यू गवर्नेंस मॉडल विच नॉट ओनली अट्रैक्ट्स द पीपल विद इन द कंट्री बट विच हैज अट्रैक्टेड लॉट ऑफ थिंकर्स, स्कॉलर्स, क्रिटिक्स फ्रॉम अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड. The best thing about the book is it covers almost all facets of governance and also the effect which is felt on ground through this governance. Uday Mahurkar ji has a long standing being a political analyst, deputy editor of India Today. So one cannot say that Mr. Mahurkar is biased towards Mr. Modi, because in his entire career, although he has several times critically analyzed the brand Modi, but at the same time, we have also seen him being critical about policies, about political decisions. So I think a person without any bias, when pens down absolutely new model of governance, it goes into a history as a reference book, and that I think Mr. Mahurkar has done successfully. As he rightly told that there are 8 chapters, and each one of them shows how India has transformed, how governance has transformed. The technological empowerment which has empowered every single person, and through the initiatives like MyGov, each one of us can get connected to the governance model. We can suggest, we can complain, we can analyze, we can criticize. For the first time, we can see a government which is really engaging people at large on the policy issues. As he rightly told, that there was a time when only few corporates were framing the policies. I don't see any problem in taking views of the corporates in policy making, because I think they are also stakeholders and they create values for us. at the same time when only a section of corporates or a singled out corporate decides a policy, we have seen that in such cases what has happened in the earlier government, 2G, 3G, coal, gas, oil fields, every single thing which ended up into a scam was a policy biased towards somebody. And for the first time in this government, we could see that everybody is participating in policy. All stakeholders can express, and policy is made for everybody. It's not for handful few. And I think the use of technology, which Mr. Mahurkar has stressed upon, has really changed the face of governance. Now with Aadhaar, if I take example of Maharashtra, in fact, for the food security, we were given a target of 7 crores. We were told that through a sample survey, you can have 7 crore people, beneficiaries of food security. And then due to agri distress, we decided to include 68 lakh more. And the central government said that these 68 lakh are not part of our scheme. You will have to finance the food security for them. We said we will finance them. And at the same time, we started Aadhaar seeding of all the ration cards and authenticating them through Aadhaar enabled system. And you will be surprised that through that, we could single out 1 crore ration cards under Food Security Act, where people were non-existent. So these 68 lakh, in spite of including them into food security, we still have a room of 30 lakh people who are identified as beneficiary at the same cost, will be able to include them. This is the difference which Mr. Mahurkar has aptly penned, that how the governance has changed through use of technology. The Bheem app and the Bheem Aadhaar app, I think it is a path-breaking innovation by any government. The Bheem Aadhaar app, which will be replacing all the digital transactions in years to come, is an innovation where a common man, many times when we talk of digitization, digitalization, innovation, we feel that a lot of people will be left out. But Bheem Aadhaar app, where Aadhaar is your KYC and your thumb impression is your bank, is your checkbook, is your passbook, is everything. And through a very small device, all the digital transactions can be accessed by anybody who has an Aadhaar card and bank account seeded. I would say it's the biggest innovation done by any government across the world, and I'm sure in days to come, several governments from the world, across the world, will try to emulate the model of Bheem Aadhaar app. I think the use of technology, the use of social media to reach out, and he has also given example of a domestic maid Kasturi, who did not get a Jandhan account, and the employer listed this grievance on a MyGov portal, and within 3 days, the Prime Minister office took cognizance, it was conveyed to the bank, and the bank manager himself contacted and told the beneficiary that we are there to help, and the account was opened. I think this type of a system where even individual grievance is taken up and is addressed is something I think unique in this governance model. He has also talked about Team India, and I think the federalism, which we are very proud of, has been transformed into cooperative federalism and competitive federalism. Cooperative in a sense, for the first time, the central government and the state governments are sitting together, taking decisions, are cooperating. Earlier, in the days of planning commission, the central government and the planning commission were greater gods, and the inferiors were the state governments, who used to go to the planning commission, used to plead, and if planning commission is fair enough and happy enough with your pleading, they would sanction you some funds. Now this is done away, and the Niti Aayog, which is a participatory platform for all the governments, whether it's central government or state governments, are sitting together and are taking decisions. Every single committee of Niti Aayog is chaired by a chief minister, and a group of chief ministers with a chair are taking decisions. So for the first time in the cooperative federalism, every single state has got a voice, and it is no more that the central government is a greater god. Everybody is participating and taking a decision. This is the spirit of Team India, and I think that is why Mr. Modi has been successful in implementing GST, because GST is one law where every single state, every single political party, every single ideology has converged and has agreed to be part of not only the law but also the GST Council, which is actually taking all the decisions. So I think this cooperative federalism, the Team India, and at the same time the competitive federalism, where states are competing, as rightly said by Mr. Mavurkar, that India witnessed highest FDI inflow in the FY16, and the states were competing to get more and more FDI. And I am happy to tell you, Mr. Mavurkar, that Maharashtra has led the way, and 50% of the FDI has come to Maharashtra. But I would credit it to this competitive federalism, because due to this competitive nature, we were very keen. We marketed our state, we went to different countries, we went to different businesses. We did the entire entire exercise of ease of doing business, and through which we attracted a lot of investment. I think the basic idea of Mr. Modi's government is not just reform. Reform is a process. The idea is transform, transformation. Transformation is end result. This is one government which is not satisfied with only process. It is satisfied only when it gets results. And I think this process of transformation is rightly penned in this book, while talking about infrastructure, how the roads are being created, how we have doubled the speed of creating roads, how the ports have become profit-making entities, and also transparency, which is a key, where when the oil fields are being bidded, how transparently the government could do it, and how several companies, several bidders who earlier did not get a chance to bid got the chance, and that has marginalized all the cost and corruption. I think every single aspect of transparency is also expressed through this book. I think several, as he has rightly said, anecdotes, because we can claim many things through our policy initiatives, but anecdotes are something which clearly shows whether they have resulted into actual ground reality or not. And several such anecdotes we can experience into this book. He has also commented on demonetization and how it was a gamble, but how decisively Prime Minister Modi ji did it and how he stood by it. I think that was one of the biggest steps. And normally in a political situation where you have a lot of support from the people, the tendency is status quoist. You tend to become, to maintain the status quo. Why should you disturb yourself is a style of working. But in spite of knowing that through demonetization there will be a lot of turmoil, it may go against, but one thing which Mr. Mavukar has mentioned rightly about Mr. Modi, transparency is something which is very close to him, and absolutely there is no compromise on the principle of transparency. On the principle of transparency, the initiatives taken by this government, fight against black money, demonetization, and how it resulted is beautifully penned by the author, and I think it gives a different perspective as well, because all of us are on his side, but being a journalist, every journalist is also insider. So what goes into a process is known to a journalist, it's not known to people like us. And how the process unfolded, what was going through, what was the impact, is beautifully told by Mr. Mavukar. About the foreign policy, as rightly said, that India is not a big country. Every single step in a foreign policy taken by Mr. Modi is very thoughtful. Initially, people started criticizing Mr. Modi that look, he is going outside and he is going to countries and he is going to places, and will that help? For the first time, we see the entire world with us. There was a time, forget the world, even our smallest neighbor like Nepal or Sri Lanka was also not with us. And now is a time where every single country feels pride to establish bilateral relation with India. This is the foreign policy of Mr. Modi. And he has understood the power of India, the power of Indians, the power of diaspora. All the Indians living abroad, we are billion plus here, but quarter of our population also resides in several countries. And now in every single country, an Indian who is residing there, a person from Indian origin, is contributing into the economy, into the digital revolution of that country immensely. So he is not just a person of Indian origin, but he is a person who can influence the policies of that country towards India. And for the first time, Modi ji realized has realized this potential and has consolidated this potential for the first time. What was started by Atalji, as rightly mentioned by Mr. Mahurkar, the potential of our NRIs is consolidated by Mr. Modi, and we can see that this Indian diaspora is playing a very important role into shaping of our bilateral relations. I think this is a very interesting book. Each one of us should read, especially the model of governance which it describes is something to emulate for the states also. We are learning a new type of governance, as rightly said by Mr. Tavade, that we are learning absolutely new set of rules for governance which ensures transformation. I am sure under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, in very short span, the country has changed and it will change for better. And I think such books like Marching with a Billion will make this process of transformation reach every single individual. So I would again like to congratulate Shri Uday Mahurkar ji, and I would urge each one of you to read this book. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.